Sitaram Yechury, CPM Polit Bureau member, is joining me on the News Hour Direct. Mr. Yechury, why do you think the situation has come to this point? And the manner in which Sudipto has been killed, why do you think the situation has reached this point in Bengal?
It's most unfortunate, and I do not have the words to describe it, but it's clearly an attempt to stifle democratic protest, and particularly from the who are now becoming more and more enlightened and more conscious, and this is no way to treat a democratic peaceful protest. And he was a very, very bright student. I mean, I've known him, and it's very unfortunate, very, very unfortunate.
You knew Sudipto personally, Mr. Yechury?
Yes, I met him once personally, and I'm not that I knew him very well, but what my impression is that he was a very bright spark.
Mr.
India cannot afford to lose such people.
Certainly not. I think it is ridiculous. If police personnel are used like private armies by politicians, which is seems to be the case here.
And it only smacks of a fascistic order that's coming. It's not merely anarchy. There seems to be a design behind this. And that is very, very dangerous.
Mr. Yechury, however, why have you done enough? I mean, the general feeling has been, pardon my saying so, that the senior left leadership of India has been waiting for more and more such incidents to happen. It hopes that Mamata Banerjee will self-destruct in an inability to govern. And you have not been strident enough in talking
not
about the political violence in Bengal since she took over.
No, absolutely, we have been, you know, please understand one thing. I have been the president of the SFI in my student days. We had coined the slogan called study and struggle. And we have been adhering to that all along. And violence in student politics is something that we abhor. And that is something which is not something on which we will capitalize in order to gain support or to make political gains. And we have fought such violence, we'll continue to fight such violence, and SFI will be in the forefront against this. And this sort of political violence that has been happening since the last assembly elections in West Bengal, we have been the victims of it. And we have been voicing our protest, mobilizing people, urging them to come forward and say, to look at the situation, saying that today it may be us, but slowly it will descend to anybody who will express any dissent. And that is what fascism is all about.
I agree with you, but Mr. Yechury, let me remind you that just like M.K. Narayanan today is critical of Mamata Banerjee government over the rising incidence of political violence, you will remember that your government, the left-front government, was also at the receiving end of Gopal Krishna Gandhi's comment when he talked in August 2009 about a veritable thunder of political violence happening in Bengal.
Absolutely, you cannot find any other party which has been as self-critical as we have been on any such incidents that have happened in the past. Also said that it is not a one-way game, a one-end game. There was provocation enough. And for over a decade in Bengal, you had what is called the Panskura line, and where you had violence being brought into the politics. And that was a stage when things shouldn't have happened what had happened. But the point is to understand what is the genesis of it. I would like you to show one democratic protest that was attacked in the manner in which these protests are being attacked today in Bengal.
But where is your central leadership,
and
sir?
With
all respect, sir, where is your central leadership? This incident has been covered non-stop on national media. It's a national event. I'm sorry to say this, sir, but where is the CPM top leadership? Why is Prakash Karat, why is Sitaram Yechury, why is Brinda Karat not there in Kolkata today to be shoulder to shoulder with the SFI
Sitaram
activists?
Sitaram Yechury is here today. He's issued this statement on behalf of the PB, of the Politburo, We will go to Calcutta. Things are happening where other parties are also being talked to. The left parties are being talked to. But voicing protest in Delhi is also equally important. It's not only a Calcutta event. Unfortunately, even in the for the wrong things, what Calcutta thinks today or Bengal thinks today, India thinks tomorrow. Before that happens, we have to stop this. We have to stop this in Delhi. We have to stop this in India. And since the moment you started covering it on your channel, Mr. Arnab, you will recollect, I was the first one to get back to you and to react with you.
Yeah.
And it was near close to midnight. It was close to midnight that that your channel took a phono from me.
Yeah.
And I think you are doing a great service for democracy in India, because these are the things that need to be nipped in the bud, and we can't allow any state government to be in a state of denial.
Absolutely.
Of this nature.
Well, Mr. Yechury, let me say this. The reason we are covering it is not because we are pro-CPM or pro any party or anti anyone.
I understand.
It's because if student politics is to be snuffed out in the manner that this this young boy has been killed, the 22-year-old had been killed, I'm sure it reminds you of your days as a student leader, then Sitaram Yechury wouldn't be sitting in front of me today. If student politics were to be snuffed out like this.
I entirely agree with you. That's why I came. That what you're doing is service to Indian democracy, I said, not to the SFI or to the CPM. I'm putting it in the larger context. Student politics is actually the conscience of any society.
That's so true.
And it is the voice of the future. And if that is going to be stifled, there's no future for the nation. And in that sense, whether we belong to whichever political spectrum, this is something that cannot be allowed, it cannot be tolerated.
Well,
and the callousness of the state government is still very, very, I mean, it's very strange that till now, after 24 hours are over, after the wide coverage of this in the national media, there is no reaction from the state government to order a judicial probe or to take action. Nothing positive has come out of it.
Well, what do you make of Mamata Banerjee's comment? She had a rather supercilious comment. She said all killings are unfortunate and our people have also been attacked in the past, etc.
I mean, what can one say? I mean, there cannot be anything more callous about it. I mean, it's most incredulous. I mean, and in a sense, for a chief minister, as the custodian of law and order in the state, instead of giving confidence to the people that this sort of anarchy, this sort of militancy will not be allowed, that the police will not be used as the political arm of the state government, instead of giving any such confidence or assurance, on the contrary, there's a sort of a justification of what has happened. And that itself is reprehensible.
Well, Mr. Yechury, I thank you very much for joining us here today. Someone gets a sense that this is a turning point in what's happening in Bengal. We can have any kind of political confrontation, but not violent confrontation, and you cannot crush student politics
Absolutely.
With such acts. Mr. Yechury, I thank you for talking to me on the news tonight.